back with another video, and before we even get into this fantastical video, I'm gonna need you to click on that subscribe button so I can be a part of your journey, you can be a part of my journey, and we can be on this journey of finding Rixang a husband together, sweetie. So you know how I've been doing this series. The first thing I did, I learned my love language, you know, because so that I can know how I need to be loved by my future husband. The second video I did a am I ready for marriage quiz, and we found out that I'm ready for marriage, and wow, we found out that I'm amazing, yay. I'm an amazing Makoti or whatever. So today, obviously, we need to know the type of guy that I'm gonna marry. So today we're taking a what kind of guy should I marry quiz. I'm telling you, we're really moving. We're on the up and up. If you guys want to do it, you guys will tell me, then I'll put the link in the description. But I'm not sure. I just feel like on this channel, I'm the one that's ready for marriage. It's not a collective thing, you know what I'm saying? So I just feel like I'm going to keep these links to myself. But the love language one, I did put in just so that you can know how your friends should love you. Cool. Also, can we note how cute I look? Also, can we get me, like, this wig is an old wig. Like, hey, you know, hi movie. It's stuff, you know what I'm saying? And also, like, I have to put this on to hide because it's not like those bougie ones. So, guys, if you guys can just spam these hair companies and tell them they need to send me a wig. And a wig that I don't have to stick. Nah, I don't know how to stick that thing. And I already know that I don't know how to stick that thing. So, I wonder if they can give me... Oh, yeah, I mean, they can give me the one with the fringe. But I like bobs, as you can see, bobs. Even to my matric dance, I had a bob. So, like, I just like bobs. So, you must ask them that they can... They please send me, like, a bob. You know, or something cute, you know what I'm saying? Even if they send me something long, but it must be nice and cute and like minimal sticking if I do have to stick, but hopefully no sticking, because I don't know how to stick, and I don't want to come here and lie to you guys about how I know how to stick when I don't know how to stick the wig. But anyways, what kind of guy should you marry? It says marriage is a big deal, which it is. Marriage is a big deal, guys, hey? But like I said, if you feel like you need to take a test to know if you're ready for marriage, you're probably not ready for marriage. And another thing I said is, if you consulted with God and God says you're not ready for marriage, then you're not ready for marriage. Then stop playing. Don't be on this thing. And no, you know what I'm saying? Cool. When you pick a guy to marry, it's a huge decision. You're choosing a man who is going to be your best friend for life. Possibly the father of your children. Guys, how many kids do you want? Oh my gosh, next we should do a quiz on how many kids should I have. Right? I'm sure there's a quiz for that. There's a quiz for everything. Who's going to be a part of your family and is also going to be your financial partner. Like I said in the last video, I'm going to contribute 10 rand and he's going to contribute 1 million. And we're just going to be so happy as financial partners. Right? It only makes sense. We don't do the sex before the marriage here. So. Okay, so we're about to start the quiz. Are you at a place right now in your life where you would want to be married? Let me give you guys options. But I think, personally, I'm at a place in my life where I'm ready to be married. Are my parents ready for me to be married? No. Has God said, go get married? No. But do I feel like I'm ready to be married? Yeah, I just feel like I'm such an amazing catch that God is not ready to shame me. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just like, I got enough love for you and my husband, God. You know what I'm saying? So that's a conversation me and God are still having. We're like, I have enough love for you and I'm going to have enough love for my husband. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, can we... and if you guys have been subscribers on this channel for long, you know that there's a video where I was talking about singleness, and I said God told me I should be single for 3 years. It's only been a year, guys. But I just feel like I went back to God and I was like, come on, let's negotiate. Surely I might have not heard you correctly. I think you said a year and a half. No. God needs to understand that, like, he's always number one in my life and he'll always be number one in my life. So come on, you know what I'm saying? I am gorgeous. Imagine, okay, You lock down, okay, you go to bed, you sleep, and you wake up, and you wake up next to your man, and you're just like, oh my gosh, and you can lick his face because he's right there, you know what I'm saying? What would you want to do right after you got married? Spend some time at home relaxing, wait a minute! For me, I just feel like after getting married, I just want my husband and I to just have at least 6 years, 5 to 6 years of us just enjoying each other. Like, I don't want us to have our firstborn until, like, maybe the sixth year of marriage. It's time for the big day. What sort of wedding would you like to have? I'd like to have a small wedding. Like, I feel like, if I'm being 100% honest, I don't even think that I'm going to invite my whole entire family to my wedding. I'm just going to invite, like, the people who have been there and the people, like, honestly, like, guys, we can't invite that one grandmother that kissed me one time to my wedding. Like, come on, guys, really? Like, what is expensive? And I just feel like more than anything, it's a day just to celebrate us. So why must we now be inviting, like, it's time to start a family. Or is it? How many kids do you want? I feel like I said in my last video that I want to adopt. My firstborn should be adopted. So after that, he can tell me how many kids he wants. But I'm going to say 3 or more just to be safe. Because the first ones won't be adopted. So that's number one. And then I could give birth to 2 kids. I don't mind 2 kids. But now if we're talking about 5, 6, I give me 0. I mean, I've watched birth videos. Those things do not look like fun. A job that would satisfy me is being a full-time YouTuber or being a full-time editor. Obviously, I want to work on my skill, how to make it perfect, but that would be my ideal work. I feel like I'm fun to hang out with. I don't think I'm so much a good listener. I mean, I'm trying. Hey, I'm really trying to be a good listener. Like, I notice now when I interrupt people while they're speaking. So I'm really trying to be a good listener. And I don't judge people. I don't think I judge people. I hope I'm not a judgmental person. Ooh, I really hope I'm not a judgmental person. It's first date time. What do you want to do? Go to a movie. Why would you go to a movie on your first date? How are you guys supposed to talk and, like, hike a mountain? Yo, give me zero. Go for a walk on the beach. I'd rather go out to dinner for the first date just so that we can look each other in our ass and, like, fall in love. And just talk, you know, ask each other very serious life questions. Like, do you tithe? Because if you do not find the house of the Lord, how are you going to find me, sweetie? You know what I'm saying? Like, we have to ask those serious questions, you know. Is there anybody who thinks they're in a relationship with you, you know? Why do you serve God? Why do you serve God? Why is having a relationship with God important to you? You guys, hey, I'm ready. I'm ready for my first date. I'm ready. I got these questions on lock. Hey, might even ask for proof of payment for the tithe just to be sure they actually do tithe. How important is it to you that your husband be good in bed? Yeah, okay. Do you care how well he gets along with your family? Yes. Like, I've seen, like, my cousins have, like, really good husbands who, like, get along with the family. They blend in with the family. I cannot have you coming here and you don't blend well with my family. Like, my family is such a nice family that I want you to blend. And I want you to be able to laugh at their jokes because they're funny. And you need to also come with your own jokes. Like, you need to blend in. Like, you need to be there like you've been family and you are, like, you know. So, that is totally important. That is totally important. Would you rather have a job that you hate that pays $100,000 a year or a job you love? That, I mean, I think a job I love, truly, because I mean, I did leave the engineering degree that I was studying, so clearly money doesn't mean everything to me. Do you own any dogs? Oh my gosh, I want to own dogs. So I'm gonna say theoretically, I mean, I don't have one right now. I do like dogs. So I'm gonna say yes, I have more than one, because theoretically I'm gonna have more than one, right? I'm gonna have 2. So I'm even gonna have a turtle. Oh my gosh, what a happy family. I'm gonna have a hamster, a turtle, or tortoise. What's the one that walks on the floor? What's the one that walks on the floor, B? Tortoise.
I think so.
I'm gonna have a tortoise, I'm gonna have a hamster, and I'm gonna have a poodle and a bulldog. You found out your husband cheated on you. What would you do? Go to counseling, ignore him. Hire a lawyer. Hire a lawyer. Yo, who do you think you are? Cheating on me? First of all, you're lucky I even gave you the chance to be my husband, sweetie. Do you expect your husband to make more than you do? I don't think that matters. There's an option here that says money is the root of all evil. I mean, but you need money. But I just feel like he must have a job. I mean, like a decent job, but it's not everything. Like, it's not a must. He must earn more than me. Why? I don't know. I feel like the only time it will be a problem is when it's, like, it's affecting him. Like, if now I must, oh my gosh, crazy rich Asians. If now I must hide all the things I'm buying because you're insecure about you making less than me, then no, it's not going to work. Then sorry, bye. But if you're not an insecure person and you're secure in who you are and you know that I chose you knowing how much you earn anyways, then we'll be fine. How clean do you tend to keep your place? I mean, currently it's not the cleanest, but it's not dirty. It's not a mess. And I wish I had a clean person. I'm just gonna say it's pretty clean. It's not really clean, it's pretty clean. What was your vibe when you were in high school? I didn't have one. I was popular, I was a good student, I was cool. And like it's baby. But to people who went to high school with me, please comment down below what type of person, what vibe was I in high school? Nobody liked me. I don't think I was popular. I was those people that everybody knew, yes, but nobody liked me. So I'm just gonna say I was a good student. I was very mean in high school. You guys need to thank God that I got saved because I was not fun to be around. Okay, what kind of guy should you marry? It says, I should marry a loyal person. It says, once you give your heart, you give it forever. You're the type that is 100% loyal to those in your life, and you need to marry a guy that is the same. You want a man that never strays from you and takes all his responsibilities at home seriously. Yes, when you two say I do, it will be for keeps. Guys, oh my gosh, I'm okay. I'm down for a dude like that. So if you know that you're a dude like that and you go to CRC, because I'm not about to leave CRC for a gent, never. So if you are a loyal guy and you fit that description and you go to CRC, yeah, and you're preferably older than me, like more than 5 years older than me, because I don't know, just preference. Do the right thing. My socials are in the link. Oh my gosh, do the right thing. I do not shoot my shot, so I will not shoot my shot at you. So if you feel like you have a chance, take me out for coffee. Take me out for dinner. Let's see. You know. But anyways, that is it from me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, go watch the other ones. Hopefully, you guys have already watched those. Also, take a screenshot of me and post it on Twitter and at me and say, wow, she looked so beautiful in today's video. Because I look beautiful in today's video. And I really hope you enjoyed this video. And love and light. And I will see you guys next time. And oh, I forgot to say, I love you, but Jesus loves you more. Oh, baby, 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 baby. What a catch. Whoever's going to marry me is really going to be blessed. And that's on period. That's on menstrual cycle. And that's on full stop. Poo-poo. Thanks. Bye.